Hello everyone, and welcome you all for a 2-week online internship program on demystifying IoT security for digital world. Myself Santosh Rathod, assistant professor from Department of Information Technology. In this video, we will be dealing with the CubCarbon simulator, the CubCarbon IoT simulator. So in this tutorial, we will be going on with the simulator that is used for implementing the smart cities using the different nodes and the wireless sensor network. So here we will look at what exactly is a CubCarbon. So a CubCarbon is a smart city and Internet of Things wireless sensor network simulator. The main objective is to design, visualize, debug, and validate the distributed algorithm for monitoring environmental data collection, etc., and to create environmental scenarios such as fire, gas, mobiles, and generally within the educational and the scientific projects. The CubCarbon offers two simulation environments. The one is the design of mobility scenario and the generation of natural events, and the another one is the representing a discrete event simulation of the wireless sensor. The first simulation environment enables the design of mobility scenarios and the generation of natural events such as fires and gas, as well as the simulation of mobiles such as vehicles and flying objects. The second simulation environment represents a discrete event simulation of wireless sensor network, which takes into account the scenarios designed on the basis of the first environment. Here we have listed the few CubCarbon features. The networks can be designed and prototyped by an ergonomic and easy to use interface using the OpenStreetMap framework. When coming to the second feature, it includes a script called SenseScript, which allows to program and to configure each sensor node individually. Then it allows to generate code for simple network and algorithms. The CubCarbon simulation is based on the application layer of the nodes. It offers the possibility to simulate algorithms and scenarios in several steps. As far as IoT is concerned, CubCarbon offers the possibility to use the MQTT protocol in an easiest way. Then adding on to the some more features, you can publish message, subscribe to many topics, and use any broker you want. You can integrate virtual and real IoT nodes like the ESP32, Android, iOS, and other nodes in the same simulation. Next comes the installation of the CubCarbon. To install the CubCarbon simulator, there are prerequisites. The one is that you need a latest version of the JDK installed on your system and the CubCarbon jar executable CubCarbon jar file, which is downloaded from the CubCarbon official website. For the installation step, you should visit or navigate to the website CubCarbon.com. So once you land on this page, you can see the download now button. So you have to click on this one and this will download the CubCarbon simulator jar file, but you should have a pre-installed Java on your system. So when you click on this one, you will get the CubCarbon file. Since I have already installed one version of the CubCarbon file, so it shows the zip file will get downloaded, and then you have to extract the zip file. So when we extract the zip file, I have pre-installed on this one. So after extracting the zip file, so here is the folder. In this folder, we will find an executable jar file. So on this jar file, you have to double click on it. So this will launch the Cub Carbon simulator. So this is the Cub Carbon simulator here. So this is the Cub Carbon environment. So after executing the Cub Carbon jar file, you can see the Cub Carbon working environment, and this is the user interface. So here, as you see, the part that is labeled by one is the map in the center. Then you have the part that is labeled with the number two is the menu bar on the top. Then the part that is labeled as three is the toolbar, which is below the menu bar. Then we have the part that is labeled by four is the parameter menu on the left. Then we have the state bar, okay, at the bottom, the console, okay. So that is the state bar, so at the bottom, and then the sixth one, we have the console, okay, and it is separated from the main interface. So they have different functionalities of all the six parts of the Cub Carbon user interface. We can just click on them and we can explore more on that one. So we'll just go through that one, and further we will be going with the execution of the writing the script and executing a sample program in this environment. So in this environment, you can see the maps here, and you can just see with the changes if you need it in dark or on the white, or if like you can use for the Google map as well. Then next we have the menu bar, okay. So here we have different options here in the menu bar. Then we can click on the project, and there are multiple options here with the different options on the menu bar. Then you can go with the edit to do the undo, then add. This menu bar button is used for adding the sensor, then the directional sensor node, and the different types of the entity. And here you can see the display tab as well. Okay, then we have the selection tab, then we have the solver tab, then the simulation tab to run and stop the simulation, and to see the script window, then the map which we have already dealt with out, and the personal tab as well. So you can click with all the different tabs and the menus, and you can explore more on this one. You can also refer the official user guide of this Cub Carbon, and you can show the additional functionalities of the different sensors and the different options available here. But due to the time constraints, I'm just be dealing with the one of the simulation with the basic program on the Hello World simulation. So we will just take into consideration the Hello World program for our the simulation purpose here. So first of all, what we have to do is we have to create a new project. Okay. So for that, we have to click on the project. Okay. And then we can click on the new project here. Okay. We can click this way. So here we get a new project. So after clicking on this project, and the you can click here on the new project, or you can also click on this button, the new project. Okay. So once you click on this new project, so you will get the desired directory where you want to create your project. So we have to choose the name of the program. So here, say in our case, we will take as the Hello World. And then we have to place it where we want to save our project. Okay. So this project, we will save here. Say in my PC, I'm saving it here at the desktop. Okay. Fine. So this will be saved as type as the Cub Carbon. and then I will save here. So after creating the project, you will find the folder that we gave the name with the project as the Hello World. So once you click on this Hello World, you can see the different folders created within this one. So as you remember, we have created the Hello World project on the desktop, and within that, when the Hello World project, we get this much files created by default. Okay. So inside this folder, we have the content of the each of the directory. So here, this config. So this config folder, it contains the simulation parameter files. Okay, which is the building the list file. Then we have the GPS. Okay. It contains the list of the routes. Then we have the logs. It contains the log files. Then we have the results. It contains the simulation results. Then we have the scripts, which contains the SendScript files of the project. Then we have the NAT event. Yeah, it contains the natural event files. Then the temp and the network. Okay, so these are used by the simulator. Okay. Now we will go on to the next step, which is the adding the new sensor node on the map. So just navigate to your Cup Carbon here, okay? And then we have to click on the either of the sensor here. So this is the sensor here, okay? So either I can add a sensor node by clicking on this one or from the menu bar here, okay? So here you can add the sensor. Let's say click on this one and add sensor, or you can use this one. So suppose if I'm adding in sensor, and then I just have to click on the this one. So this one, by one click, the sensor gets added. If you add multiple, if you click on multiple times on this screen like this way, then it will get adding multiple times. So to overcome that, when you have to just right click on your on the mouse, right click the mouse so that it will stop getting this one. So suppose this one I'll get, and then I will remove this one. Okay. So I've created these two sensors here. Now, after adding on the sensors here, the next step is to open the SendScript window. Okay. So for opening the SendScript window, we have to click on the go to the simulation, and then the SendScript window we have to select here. Okay. So here we can select this one, or else you can write here, okay, for this window. So after adding on the sensor, the better we'll use the simulation from here, and then the SendScript editor, okay? And then this is the area where we will write our script, okay? So here, suppose this is the here, so I'll just add on, say, print, say, Hello World, and then I'll stop this, and then say we have to, after dumping in the script, okay, then we have to add the name of the script in the file name field here, okay? So, and then we'll say we'll give it the file as the Hello. Okay, so after doing that one, then we have to save, and that will get saved here. And then finally, we have to close this SendScript window. So after writing the script, the next thing is to assign the SendScript file to the sensor node. So we will click here. Okay, so once it gets highlighted, then we see, okay, this node is now selected, the sensor, and then we have to add the parameter to this one. So here we have to assign the values or the parameters to the node. So for that, we will be selecting the node here, clicking on this node, then we have to go to the device and parameter, and then we have to select the hello.csc script file, and then you have to simulate. Then you have to run. Click on the run. Once you click on the run, then you can see the node here gets highlighted with the orange color here. Now we have to run the simulation. To run the simulation, either we can click here or you can just under the simulation parameter, you can click on the run simulation. So either of the ways it can work, run simulation here or here. So like once you click on this run simulation, you can see the message displaying here as hello world. Okay, and that starts with the stop of the end of the simulation. So again, if you click here, then it will click the, it will display the message as hello world. Okay, so in this example, the simulation result shows like how the hello world message displayed by the sensor here. You can explore with more of the projects, the built-in projects here, and you can explore with the working of the nodes and connecting the different nodes into this one. So here we are taking this into the map, like designing of the smart cities. So same way, you can explore more on the sensors, the different types of sensors here, and then you can run with this, work with the simulation. So that's all for the simulation of the cup carbon simulator. You can explore more of the examples by referring to the official user guide of the cup carbon simulator. I hope this video was helpful to you for understanding the cup carbon simulator. Thank you everyone for your patience listening.